And welcome to our wonderful channel, Relationship Matters. This is your channel, the place whereby we talk everything and everything about relationship, about marriage, about divorce, about any situation that can happen in a relationship. So we are here to help, to give some tips that can help you to build a successful relationship, a successful marriage. As we keep on saying that a successful marriage takes hard work and commitment, because anyone who go into a relationship is there because you want to enjoy life. It should not be a burden, but rather it should be an enjoyment. Now, today we are going to talk about women. Now, for the past 2 weeks, we'll be talking about men, because men are the head of the family. So men are the captain of a ship. You know, in a ship, there must be a captain, and man is the leader. That's why we took 2 weeks to talk about men. We talk about men's obligation. We talk about what a man should know about a woman. And the video is there. You can go back to those videos. They will bless you. Now, today, we talk about women. What are the women's obligation in the relationship? Now, next week, don't miss it, we talk about what a woman should know about man. So today we are talking about women. Well, women are quite a complicated human being, just like a man. It's not easy to understand a woman. And but women also have a part to play in the success of a relationship. Women. That's why in a relationship there are two, man and woman. So a man plays his part, a woman also plays his part. Now, what are women's obligations? Women's obligations are quite also very similar to men, but because of women's characteristics, women's biology, they are a bit different. Now, the first thing you should know as a woman is that when you go into marriage, marriage in the Latin word means marital. Marital. Marital means joined to a principal body. Now you are linked to a body, right? You are attached to a body. So therefore, a woman comes to a man, you are attached to the man, right? So the man is the principal body, the woman is attached to a man. So therefore, the first thing's obligation of a woman, if you want your marriage to be successful, lady, dear lady, learn to be submissive to your husband. Learn to be submissive to your husband. Now, submission does not mean you be a slave to a man. No, rather is a sign of greatness, is a sign of strength. Be submissive simply means that listen to your man. Try to obey what your man tells you to do, your husband tells you to do, because he is the head. Remember, he's like a dad to you. You are a daughter to him. Men always lacks women who listen to them, women who are more accommodative to them. So learn to be submissive to your husband. Be submissive, as I say again. It does not mean you are weak. It does not mean you are a slave to a man. But rather, when you are submissive to your husband, you understand him better. You know what he likes, what he does not like. And you can control him easily. You see, anytime he tells you to do something, you do it. He tells you to do something, you do it. Even man himself begin to see it cannot hurt you. It cannot do anything bad to you, because you are submissive to him. You are listening to him. You are kind of obedient to him. And that is an obligation of what a woman should do in the house. Be submissive to your husband. If you listen to your husband, if you do what your husband tells you to do, your husband will love you so much. And actually, it will become weaker to you, because you begin to control him. But if you are not submissive to him, now you become like two heads in the house. Now imagine if you are driving a car, you have two people are driving the same car. What will happen to that car? Very soon the car will crash, isn't it? There must be somebody driving the car, another person is closer to him, telling you, oh, do this way. Oh, look at that, be careful. That's how it works. So the man is the driver. So whenever the man tells you to do, try to listen, obey him, and it will do good to your marriage. Your marriage will last longer. Your husband will love you more. your husband will be ready to do anything for you because you are submitted to him. So submission is the first key or obligation of a woman in a relationship. Now, the second thing is, apart from being submissive to a man, a woman must be trustworthy. Trust. Make sure your husband trusts you. Your husband trusts you. You to gain the love of your husband, let him trust you in everything. Financially, trust you. The way you are managing the things of the house, he trusts you. Trust is very important. When your husband begins to trust you, the husband is ready to give everything to you. Anything you want, he will give to you because you are trustworthy. Your husband will start boasting among his friends that, you see my wife, she's wonderful. I trust my wife in everything. Whatever my wife tells me, I do it. That trust, when the husband begins to trust you, is heaven on earth. So try, learn to trust your husband. Let your husband trust you. Make yourself trustworthy in the eyes of your husband. Okay? Your husband may travel, your husband may go anywhere, but as a woman, try to build that trust. Let your husband know that my wife is at home. When I come home, I trust my wife. She has done this, she has done that. I trust my wife. She has gone this to do that, she has gone this to do that. That is what the husband wants to see in a woman in the house. You see, your husband is working. Your husband may be going for businesses. Your husband is going for meetings, things like that. But he knows that the back of his mind that I have a woman at home. My wife, I trust her in everything. I can even give him my credit card, everything. Yes, if your husband trusts you, if your husband begins to trust you, know that this is my wife. Your husband can tell you everything about his finances, everything. So the second thing, make sure you are trustworthy to your husband. This is a woman's obligation to keep your home, to keep your house. Now, the third tip, what can help a woman to make sure your relationship is strong, to make sure that your marriage lasts longer, is pay more attention to your inner beauty, not outside beauty only. Yes, it is good for you to look beautiful. It is good for you to make sure your husband always fall in love with you. Yeah, your makeup, everything, your appearance, the way you look outside. Yes, it is good. But most especially, pay attention to your inner beauty, your inside of you. Why is it like that? Because the inside of you, that's what you are really. Your husband wants to see love. Your husband wants to see that caring attitude from you. Your husband wants to see you more tender. So walk inside of you, okay? Don't just walk outside. The inside is the beauty of a woman, a caring side, a good heart, a loving heart, a tender heart. That's what your husband wants to see. Yes, you have to make sure you look nice, you dress well, so that your husband will always fall in love with you every time. And make sure the inside of you is important. So pay more attention to your inner beauty. Also, develop what we call by a quiet spirit. A quiet spirit in order to do what? To create harmony in the house. Now, let me explain this. A man is like a lion heart. That's why God brought a woman to a man. The man is more of, strong. The woman is like a cooler. Okay, let us take an example of a car, right? We drive a car. The car has a motor, an engine. When you are driving a car, what do you need in the engine? You need water to cool the car, right? If there's no water, the engine will burn out. Your car will just, yeah? So therefore, a woman is like that water to cool the engine. When the engine in the car is driving, you need the water to cool down the engine so that the car will drive smoothly. That's how the house is. The man is that engine. The man is the one who's driving the house. The man is making the house to stand. But therefore, the woman outside of him must have a quiet spirit. And that comes for the inner beauty. When you develop your inner beauty, you develop that quietness inside of you. Every man lacked that type of wife who's close to him, who cools him down. So a man may come out, may come from work. He has problem in the work. He's thinking about how to build this, how to do the finances. You see, his heart is hot. So he needs a wife who has a quiet spirit to be close to him, to cool him down, to help him so that he can direct him, so that he can focus on the things that are needed for the house. It does not matter if you are working or not, but remember, the husband is always the head. All the responsibility comes upon your husband. Everybody, when they look at the house, they are not looking at the wife, they look at the husband. What is the husband doing? Where is the husband? What is he doing? Is he providing for the house? Therefore, the man think about many things. His head is hot. His heart is hot. So he needs a woman who has a quiet spirit, who can come close to him to cool him down. So that will create harmony in the house. Also, when there is an argument in the house, it happens. So a quiet spirit of a woman can just bring down the balance. Okay? No man like a wife who, when he's talking, she also is talking. Very rare. You find it very rare. Most of the men, that's the nature of a man. A man like when he's talking, the woman, you are, how can I say, collective. You listen to your husband. You collect everything. Cool down. Reason to talk to him back. You will be able to control your husband. Therefore, a woman should develop a quiet spirit in the house so that you can create harmony in the house. That is very important. That will create a balance in your house. That will make your marriage to last the test of time. Believe me. But if the husband, if a woman is hot-tempered, that can lead to many problems. And also, when the husband is hot-tempered, you're also hot-tempered, both of you, that marriage will very soon have trouble. So the third tip is, a woman, learn to develop your inner beauty, meaning that learn to create a quiet spirit. That is very important. The fourth thing which I have to share with you today for women. Women learn should be a mother. A woman should be what? A mother. A mother to who? A mother to your husband, a mother to your children, when you have children. Now, let me explain this. What does that mean? First and foremost, be a mother to your husband. Remember, your husband is old, like a dad to you. Or you can say is your first boy in the house. Many marriages were come to by statistic, according to the statistic in mostly in the developed world. Many marriages, they go through a deep crisis, a small crisis when children come to life. So they were together before, everything was fine. Now a child comes in, very soon, problems start. Why? Because when the child comes, it looks like the woman begins now to pay more attention to the child, to take care to the child. Now, that can be a big mistake. Why? Because believe me, your husband is the first person he came into your life, not the child. If your husband was not there, you could not have that child. Therefore, you pay attention to the child, but pay most attention to the husband. Why? When you keep on caring for your husband as you were doing before, that gives the husband love, confidence in you more, because he sees that you are taking care of him, but there's a child by your side. Your husband will come to help so that both of you can take care of the child. It's automatic, that's how it comes in. But most of the cases, the wife will try to pay more attention to the child and neglecting the husband. And that's where many crises comes into the marriage. So your husband is your first boy. So be a mother to him, meaning that take care of him. Do your best to understand your husband. Yes, do your best to understand. Understand his feelings. Understand what he likes. Understand that's the nature of men. Men love to be around a mom. So you are a mother to him. You see, if you don't pay him the attention that he wanted, you know what you are doing? You are literally pushing him out of the door. Oh, yes. Many cases you see that a man has a wife in the house, but actually he see another woman outside. You wonder yourself, why is he like it? But the wife has everything. She looks beautiful. She has everything. What is it? Certainly, that woman is not paying attention to the husband as he should be. I'm not saying it's 100%, but many cases. But when you become a mom to your husband, you try to understand him. You try to create a balance in the house, right? You're affectionate to him. You show him the love that he deserves. You show him the affection. You are gentle to him. You are tender to him. You talk to him in the nice way. You create an environment whereby he does not need to go and look for something else outside. Believe me. But when he does not find those things in the house, of course, he tries to look for something else outside. And that marriage becomes patchy, patchy, patchy. You begin just to manage it. No, marriage is not supposed to manage. Marriage begins to enjoy it when you begin to follow the rules, what we discussed before, the foundation of a marriage. When you begin to follow those rules, you don't need to manage your marriage. You have to enjoy it. You have to live that marriage. So what I'm saying is that a woman learn to be what? A mother to your husband. If you are a mother to your husband, that is what the man is looking for. You want to see that tenderness. Again, help him, the husband, to relax. You see, your husband come from work. Your husband come from a trip, come from business, anything. When he comes home, the last thing you want is argument. The last thing you want is to see a grumpy wife around him. The last thing you want is to see somebody is complaining. Therefore, as a woman, please learn to create an atmosphere whereby your husband will be happy to relax. When he's coming home, even at work, he knows that I'm going home now. My wife is there. My wife is waiting for me. When he enters the house, he knows that you are there. You welcome him with smile. You create an environment whereby he feels at home. When you create that environment, he will not be looking to from something else outside. No. There are situations whereby, which are real situation, right? A husband finished work. Instead of coming home, he say, I'm not going home. We ask, why are you not going home? Well, when I go home now, this is what will happen. My wife this. Can you imagine the man filled the tank of his car? Right? He went to work in the morning, 9 o'clock. He finished the work around 3 o'clock. He started driving around London, driving, and he come back home around 10, 11 o'clock. He avoid to see the wife. So when he comes, the children are sleeping, the wife is asleep, he go asleep. And he does that all the time. But we ask, what is going on? He said, because whenever I come home, it's quarrel. When I come home, it's fighting. When I come home, it's like this. You see, that is what happened to that marriage. That marriage cannot last. So therefore, as a mom to your husband, you create an environment whereby your husband will come to relax. Your husband always looking forward to come home because he knows that he has a wife at home. He's waiting for him. He has a mom at home. Don't make your husband miss his mom. Most cases, don't make your husband to miss his mom. There are men who are grow up with the mom will be taking care of him, so he's missing that. But you are replacing the mom in the house, you see? So create that environment whereby he will enjoy always to be there in the house. That is the fourth tip I wanted to give to you. Now, the fifth tip, what can we say? Be a helper to your husband. Now, remember, for us who are believers, in the Bible, it says clearly that first was man, Adam, then Eve came. Why did Eve came? He came to help Adam. Why? Because according to the Bible, that Adam was lonely. Okay? So the woman, you are there as a companion to your husband. You are coming to help him. Help him in all departments of life. Most especially, help him to be successful in life. The success of your husband, because you are in the marriage, remember, we are talking about marriage. We are not talking about a situation whereby you are coming to take advantage, then you go away. No, I'm talking about you are coming to build your marriage. You want to stay in that marriage. That is your marriage. That is your life. Okay? Until death separate. That is your life. Therefore, you are coming to that marriage to build it, to be a successful marriage. So your obligation is to help your husband to be successful. As we said before, that a man also, his job is to help the wife to fulfill her dream. But you also help him to be successful in life. Successful in career, successful in business, successful in ministry, successful in anything he's doing. But that comes when you become submissive to him. That comes when you begin, you have a quiet spirit to develop the balance in the house. That comes when you create an environment where your husband comes to relax. That comes when, what? When you are trustworthy to your husband. You want trust. He's not worried about you going somewhere or moving with your friend. He's not worried. He trusts you. That, it gives him the confidence to focus on what he's doing. Because you know, when he is successful, the house is successful. The children are successful. Your life is successful. He can have the means to support you. He can have the means to help you. Right? So in all, what can we say? That you are in that marriage to serve your husband. That's the bottom line of it. Marriage is about servicing one another. So you are in that marriage to serve your husband, just as your husband is also there to serve you. As we spoke before, the husband is head of the house, but is not a slave driver. No, he is just the head. He is the visionaire. But you are there to help him to fulfill those visions. That's the right word. So he has a vision that, look, in this family, we'll do this, we'll do that, we'll build it, we'll build it, we'll build that. Now you as a helper, you come and help him and say, okay, yes, let us do this, let us do this. Yes, what can we do? So you support him in any vision he brings in the house. That is your job. So what can we say? That is the tip I wanted to give you. That any man on earth, whether it's a black, a white, Asian, Arab, or in all cultures, men like women who are submissive to them. Number one, be submissive to your husband. Number two, they lack women who are, they can trust their woman, trustworthy. You have to prove that to your husband, that he can trust you in everything. Number three, you have to create, pay more attention to your inside of you to develop quiet spirit, create balance in the house. Men lack that. Number four, be a mother to your husband, to replace the mother so that you will not miss the mom. And number five, you are there to help him. When you do those things, try to do them, you will find out that your husband will fall in love with you. You'll find out that your husband will be boasting about you. When he goes with his friend, he'll be talking, I have a beautiful wife. It's not about the beauty of the body or the outside. I have a beautiful wife who has a beautiful heart, a heart of love, a heart of who appreciates me, who cooks for me, who takes care of me, who takes care of my clothes. He does things in the house. When you do that, your husband, he can even sacrifice everything for you. If the parents are trying to hold your wife, he will stand for you. He say, no, you don't know who my wife is. I have a wife. So make sure he trusts you, he can defend you. And in any land, wherever he can stand for you, he can defend you. When you do that, your husband will love you. And your marriage will stand strong. Your marriage will never crash. So this is what I wanted to share with you today. Now, don't miss next week. Next week will be even more powerful, because I'll tell you about what men lack to hear about what women should know about men. Oh, the video are crash now. Ugh.